Dear students, today topic is complex numbers objective. Of course, it is going since 3 days or 4 days, I think. In yesterday class, we have discussed about Euler's formula. Depends upon Euler's formula, we have discussed some problems in the available class of homework, everything concept. And the sums also have completed. Now, today concept is depends upon geometry. Complex numbers. Depends upon geometry, applications to geometry. Now, distance formula. Let here a is equal to z1, that is x1 plus I by 1. And B is equal to Z2, that is X2 plus I by 2. A and B are two complex numbers. A comma B are two complex numbers. A Z1 equal to X1 plus I by 2, B Z2 equal to X2 plus I by 2 are two complex numbers. Then distance between AB, that is equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z2. Of course, that meaning is root of X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y1 minus Y2 whole square. Here, according to this one, x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, you can write root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square or y1 minus y2 whole square. This is nothing but modulus of z1 minus z2. Modulus of z1 means x1 plus I by 1 minus of x2 plus I y2. So x1 plus x1 minus x2 one bracket plus of by I into, so component of I into y1 minus y2 is y1 minus y2, so root of modulus of root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square can be written as modulus of z1 minus z2. Today class is depends upon only z1 and z2, z1, z2, z1, z2, z3, like that only. Here you should understand as z1 is equal to x1 plus I by 1 and z2 is equal to x2 plus I by 2, like that. Second one, section formula. So what is the section formula? If a point means a point P Z. Z means here complex number x1, x comma y, that is right understand as x plus I is a complex number, that is Z. A complex number point P Z divides A Z1 comma B Z2 in the ratio AZ1 comma BZ2 in the ratio M is to N internally, that is like this. Put here A, this is Z1, and put here B, this is Z2, put here this is B, Z, this is M and this is M. So if AZ1 and BZ2 are two complex number, PZ dividing AB in the ratio M is to N, then you can write the concept here MZ2 plus NZ1, that's all, by M plus. This is nothing but MX2 plus NX1 comma M by 2 plus N by 1, like that the concept. Z2 meaning here X2 plus I by 2 and Z1 meaning X1 plus I by 1. So the whole can be written as P of Z is equal to MZ2 plus NZ1 by M plus N. This is second formula. Of course, if it is dividing the ratio M is to N and it is the ratio is external, then the formula MZ2 minus NZ1 by M minus N is correct. Now, midpoint concept. If AZ1 comma AZ1 comma BZ2, AZ1 comma BZ2 are two points. A Z1 comma B Z2 are two points, then midpoint of A comma B is equal to Z1 plus Z2 whole by 2. That's all. This meaning is X1 plus X2 by 2 comma Y1 plus Y2 by 2 concept of Z1 and Z2 complex numbers concept is X1 plus I1 and X2 plus I2. In the similar way we can write Z1 plus Z2 by 2. Next one, of course centroid also the same concept. If AZ1 comma BZ2, AZ1 comma BZ, AZ1, BZ2, CZ3 are three vertices of triangle. Three vertices of triangle ABC. Then centroid G is equal to Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 whole by 3. Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 whole by 3. This is the centroid. Next one. Now, if AZ1 BZ2 AZ1 BZ2 CZ3 DZ4 AZ1 BZ2 CZ3 DZ4 are four complex numbers having vertices of a quadrilateral, having vertices of a quadrilateral, then among them, if let us draw the square concept. First of all, parallelogram like this. Draw parallelogram. Using the property of parallelogram, we can say that right here this is A Z1, B Z2, C Z3, D Z4. Parallelogram meaning two opposite sides are parallel and equal. That implies, write the concept. AB is equal to CD, comma BC is equal to AD. So, what is AB here? You can write the distance between AB is modulus of Z1 minus Z2 is equal to CD, meaning is here modulus of Z3 minus Z4. Also, BC meaning also Z modulus of Z2 minus Z3 is equal to modulus of Z1 minus Z4. This is the concept of parallelogram. Next one. Also one thing we can say that diagonals are bisect each other in the parallelogram. Diagonals are bisect each other in the parallelogram. Also Z1 plus Z3 by 2 is equal to, that is, that meaning is midpoint of diagonals are equal. So Z1 plus Z3 by 2 by is equal to Z2 plus Z4 by 2. 2 get cancelled. That implies you can say here Z1 plus Z3 is equal to Z2 plus Z4. So this is the geometrical representation of complex numbers. Right, this is fifth formula. Next, sixth formula. If it is a square, it is a rhombus, first of all. Let us write rhombus. It means here A, B, C, D. Simply draw the diagram like this. Put here A, B, C, D. A meaning Z1, B meaning Z2, C meaning Z3, D meaning Z4. In rhombus, in geometrical property, we know that all sides are equal. It's okay. Next, diagonals bisect each other. And diagonals are perpendicular. Diagonals are perpendicular. So that implies Z1 plus Z3 is equal to the same concept. Diagonals bisect each other, I am discussing. Which you Z1 plus Z3 is equal to the similar concept Z2 plus Z4. Also, this is the concept of diagonals bisect each other. Also, during AB is equal to BC is equal to CD like that. So, what is meant by AD? AB. Here modulus of Z1 minus Z2. Modulus of Z1 minus Z2 is equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z3 is equal to like this. Modulus of Z3 minus Z4 is equal to modulus of Z4 minus Z1. All sides are equal. And diagonals are not equal. Also, you can write. Diagonals are not equal. So, what is diagonals? AC not equal to BD. So, modulus of Z1 minus Z3 not equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z4. This is the property. Of course, to get the slope, to get the perpendicular concept of diagonals, that is, in rhombus, two diagonals are perpendicular. To get the theory of perpendicular theory, we need to calculate simply slope, that is product of slopes is equal to minus 1. If you think this Z1 as x1 comma y1, this is x2 y2, this is x3 y3, this is x4 y4, then product of slopes is equal to minus 1 is original concept. There is no question of Z1, Z2 notation. Now, if it is a square, if it is, first we can write rectangle. If it is rectangle, draw the rectangle symbol, put here A, Z1. This is B, Z2. This is C, Z3. This is D, Z4. A, B, C, D are vertices. Now we know that the two sides are equal. Two opposite sides are equal, that implies modulus of AB is equal to modulus of CD. So, modulus of AB meaning here Z1 minus Z2, modulus of Z1 minus Z2 is equal to modulus of Z3 minus Z4. Also, two opposite sides are equal, here you can understand modulus of Z1 minus Z4, modulus of Z1 minus Z4 is equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z3. It's one thing, each side. And next one, also diagonals bisect each other. Diagonals bisect each other, that is midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. And also we know that diagonals are equal in the rectangle. So whenever diagonals are equal, then length of AC is equal to length of BD. So what is length of AC? Z1 minus Z3 is equal to what is length of BD? Z2 minus Z4. Modulus of Z2 minus Z4. This is 7.5. If it is a square, if it is a square, so all properties can be applicable for the parallelogram ABCD here. All properties meaning here AB, all sides are equal, rectangle is equal, rectangle bisect each other, and also diagonals are bisect each other, diagonals are perpendicular also. AZ1, here AZ1, BZ2, CZ3, AZ1, BZ2, CZ3, and DZ4. Now, condition is AB is equal to BC is equal to CD. So you can write here modulus of Z1 minus Z2 is equal to modulus of Z2 minus Z3 is equal to modulus of Z3 minus Z4. Modulus of Z3 minus Z4 is equal to modulus of Z4 minus Z1. Modulus of Z1 minus Z2 equal to Z2 minus Z3 equal to Z3 minus Z4 equal to Z4 minus Z1. Also, diagonals bisect each other, that is nothing but midpoint of AC is equal to midpoint of BD. So, Z1 plus Z3 is equal to Z2 plus Z4, and also diagonals are equal. Not only this one, diagonals are equal, so AC is equal to BD. So, what is AC here? Z1 minus Z3 over modulus. Z1 minus Z3 is equal to Z2 minus Z4. This is the application of geometry using the complex number. Now, let us calculate worked example 30. Somewhat mistake is there. Students, by observing old textbook, of course this is wrong. In our material, example 13 given as wrong. This is old material. During old, depends upon old material, I want to discuss with you that worked example 13. Here he given that the complex numbers z bar, the complex numbers z bar, z bar minus z minus z bar. Z bar minus z bar forms a rectangle, not form, it is not a square. In our book, he given as a square, it is wrong. Let us going to discuss about worked example 13. Prove that z bar, minus z bar forms a rectangle. z bar, minus z bar forms a rectangle. Now, let z is equal to x plus I by z bar is equal to x minus I by minus z is equal to minus x minus I by minus z bar is equal to minus x plus I by. Now, depends upon the Cartesian coordinate system. Put here, this is 0, comma 0. This is x dash, this is x. This is y dash, this is y. Draw like this. This is x comma y in Q1 plus plus. This is minus plus. So minus x comma y. This is minus minus. So this is minus x comma minus y. This is plus comma minus. So x comma minus y. According to this condition, x comma y meaning is z. So here this is a. A z. So z bar meaning x minus y. So this is z bar. So let this is d z bar. Next minus x minus y becomes minus z. This is c notation minus z, and minus x plus I by d is minus z bar. According to this one, minus z bar. This is b minus z bar. Now draw a rough diagram like this. AB. What is AB? Distance between AB. X and X will be getting cancelled by minus of minus y becomes 2y. AB is equal to 2y. In the same concept here, minus x minus x minus x minus of minus x, so plus. It is getting cancelled by minus of minus y becomes 2y. So BC is equal to 2y. AB is equal to 2y and BC is equal to 2y. Now, this is AD, not AD. AD is equal to 2y, BC is equal to 2y. Now AB you take, AB x minus half minus x becomes 2x. AB is equal to 2x and BC is equal to y, I get cancelled. Next to BC, not BC, CD. CD is equal to x minus half minus x becomes 2x. Now you can able to understand that AD is equal to BC. Two sides are equal, here also two sides are equal. And once again you can understand that the diagonals are equal in the rectangle. Now AC Here I create AC. AC is equal to like this. X minus of minus X. X plus X. X minus of minus X becomes X plus X whole square. 2X whole square becomes 4X square. Plus Y minus of minus Y whole square. This is 4Y square. So 2 into X square plus Y square. Now BD. BD is equal to also like X minus of minus X. In the similar way, you can calculate here 2 into x square plus y square. So AC is equal to BD. Here we got diagonals are equal and two opposite sides are equal. Then you can say it is rectangle and that's all. Therefore, ABCD is rectangle, not bisecting. Not bisecting also you can calculate students. X minus x by 2, 0. Y plus y, so 0 comma 0, of course 0 comma 0 is the center, no need to calculate. Simply you write here ABCD is a rectangle. ABCD is a rectangle. So work example 13 we have completed. Before going to discuss about work example 14 and 15, let us write the collinear concepts and the formula which are needed. You should write formula is 7 completed maybe. 7, 8 completed. Now, 9th formula. If z, comma, z1, z2, z3, 3 letters. If z1, comma, z2, comma, z3 are collinear. Z1, comma, z2, comma, z3 are collinear. If and only if, in first, not first, in the IPA, exercise C, exercise C, Roman number 3, first question, we proved that modulus of z3 minus z1. Roman number 3, first question, we proved here, so z3 minus z1 by z2 minus z1 is a real number. If it is a real number, we have taken imaginary part equal to 0 and depends upon that sum we have said that, I said the fourth question in Roman number 3. So you can understand by using this one, z3 minus z1 by z2 minus z1 is a real number. Purely real example. Z3 minus Z1 by Z2 minus Z1 is purely real. So whenever Z3 minus Z1 by Z2 minus Z1 is purely real, then Z1, Z2, Z3 are linear also. This is okay, a theorem also. According to determinant theory. Determinant theory, we said that X1 by 1, 1, X2 by 2, 1, X3 by 3, 1 equal to 0. Our area of the triangle formed by X1 by 1, X2 by 2, X3 by 3 equal to 0. Therefore, now you can say that Z1 here, yeah, according to that one. This is geometrical theory, right? Like this Z1, Z1 bar, Z1, Z1 bar, Z2, Z2 bar, Z3, Z3 bar is equal to 1. Z1, Z1 bar, Z2, Z2 bar, Z3, Z3 bar 1 is equal to 0. This is determinant. Determinant of general conjugate belonging to 1 is nothing but area of triangle that is equal to 0. And also argument of z2 minus z1 equal to z3 minus z1. Yeah. Argument of z2 minus z1. Argument of z2 minus z1 equal to argument of z3 minus z1. R slope concept. Slope concept. Slope concept meaning here z3 is equal to like t2 minus t1. T2 minus t1 is equal to understand, try to understand t2 minus t1 equal to t3 minus t2. So here z2 minus z1 is equal to z3 minus z2. Z2 minus Z1 equal to Z3 minus Z2, that implies you can understand Z3 plus Z1 is equal to 2 Z2. Z3 plus Z1, Z3 plus Z1 is equal to 2 Z2, therefore Z1 comma Z2 comma Z3 are in AP. Z1 comma Z2 comma Z3 are in AP for the collinearity condition.